Welcome, everyone. You join us at the Autodromo José Carlos Pache, or Interlagos, as it's affectionately known. It's practice time, it's Brazil, and it's great to have you with us.
They told you about the new parts that have come in from the factory, right? Well, they're all fitted and good to go. I hope they do the trick. Let's get a few laps under our belt. Okay, DRS zone coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD. Okay, we need a few solid laps here to help us calculate a good race strategy.
Thank you.
temperature's so important for your tyres. Cool down laps are now vital after a push lap so that we don't light up the rubber too much, not to mention recharging the battery. This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slip through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex. Program complete and a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers.
What? It's a Saturday showdown. Anyone fancy some hot laps around Interlagos? It's qualifying day here for the Sao Paulo Grand Prix.
Thank you.
Forget pit stops, forget fuel management. It's pedal to the metal all the way here as we get ready for today's sprint. It's an unusual anti-clockwise race here at Interlagos, where the Sao Paulo locals are packed into the grandstands at each of the 15 corners around this classic 2.7-mile circuit. Two very fast sections bookend the famous and highly technical Sector 2, where getting a good run out of Junsao into one of the two DRS zones will be key to any overtaking prospects today. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's sprint. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And Nico Hülkenberg completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Norris, Fernando Alonso, Sainz, Perez, Hamilton, Oscar Piastri, Russell, Stroll, Tsunoda, Albon, Magnussen, Ricciardo, Joe, Sargeant, Gasly, Bottas, and Esteban Ocon lines up at the back of the grid. Which of these drivers will get pole position today? We'll soon find out. And striding into our commentary box to join us today, the man, the myth, the legend, Anthony Davidson.
Well, they say that a change is as good as a rest, and whilst there's not much rest on show in the sprint format today, there's definitely a change to what we're usually seeing on the track. Let's look at their season, and particularly against...
Radio check.
Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of this lap. No rain expected for the time being. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get a good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Make a mistake. For a bit of understeer when trailing the car ahead. They're going to be giving off dirty air, which is going to affect our tyres, so try to get past. So we've been looking at the damage and we think we should be okay to continue. It's going to cost us a little bit of time, but we're nearly at the end of the race. Ferrari drivers just completed a pass for the lead of the race. Final lap of the race.
So with the sprint concluded, join us next time for qualifying. And of course, the main event, this weekend's Formula One Grand Prix. We'll see. It's a Saturday showdown. Anyone fancy some hot laps around Interlagos? It's qualifying day here for the Sao Paulo Grand Prix. Welcome along then to where heroes and history are made. It's where the 2008 title was decided in the very final corner. And just 1 year later, Jenson Button stormed through from 14th on the grid to claim his one and only Drivers' Championship. It's time then for the Sao Paulo Grand Prix. We're racing today then at Interlagos, a historic 2.7-mile circuit and one of the few anti-clockwise tracks on the calendar. 15 corners in total, 9 to the left and 6 to the right, with a technical middle section opening up to a flat-out Sector 3. That gives us our best passing opportunity down into Turn 1. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Fernando Alonso lines up on pole position, and it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Sainz, Norris, Perez, Oscar Piastri, Hamilton, Stroll, Russell, Hülkenberg, Albon, Magnussen, Gasly, Tsunoda, Ricciardo, Ocon, Bottas, Joe, and Logan Sargeant. It's almost time for those 5 red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. And alongside me in the commentary box today, a man who I always look up to, which is easier said than done, Anthony Davidson. Let's look at their season, and particularly against their teammate. Fair to say, they've got the better of them more often than not. Now, you're the racing driver in this partnership, so tell us about this racing driver. Put us in their shoes. How are they going to be feeling?
Well, you've got to be prepared, Crofty. Before you even step foot inside the car, you've got to know, you've got to have a pre-race game plan. You've watched videos before you get into the car of previous races gone by. You know where you have to place your car if X, Y, or Z happens in front of you or behind you. So having this clear game plan is absolutely essential before you get in the car.
The boss wants another podium finish this weekend. I know you're more than capable.
Radio check.
Clutch bite is good. Gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Threat of rain for the time being, conditions look good. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. now use DRS. DRS now available. Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Time to the car behind. Okay, good work. Great pass. Experience some understeer now that you're in the wake of the car ahead. Try to get past as soon as possible. So we're leading our teammate by 3.9 seconds. Okay, the car head's beginning to pull away. You know what to do. Right, we need to get past here. Use overtake, use overtake. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, Nico. Okay, Russell's ahead. Can't let them hold us up for too long, so let's try and get past as soon as possible and crack on. Push, push. Okay, really, really good. You hit that target nicely. There's a long way to go in this race, so let's keep it clean. Right, let's not stay behind this car for too long. We need to get past. box this lap and push. Remember, box this lap. Keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach and make sure you don't speed. Okay, don't worry. Okay, forget the... Okay, don't worry about that target for now. Let's just focus on this pit stop. Kevin's in the pits. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, you're in the top 10. The Ferrari driver's just moved into first place. great manoeuvre. You made it look so easy. Our teammate by 15.1 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in 13th place. Your last lap time, 1 minute 10.6. Okay, clear. win that place back. Right, we need to get past here. Use overtake, use overtake. Starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 a lap. Gap to your teammate behind, 19.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. Time last lap, 1:11.3. flag. Here's some information on Russell for you. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car. Final lap.
For Charles Leclerc as he takes the checkered flag and wins.
Race win, fastest lap as well, so that extra point for them today. And what a masterful performance. They really showed a clean pair of heels to the rest of the opposition out there today. They had no answer for them.
Here come our winners now, a thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.
OK, mate, I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but I'm afraid to say that some of them have failed quality control. We're going to need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.